During the liberation of Paris, one bit of interesting film was shot. In this reel, you will see French tanks trying to clear out a building. The steward in the foreground is eventually hit by an object, and then the clip ends. We're going to have a look at that clip today and trying to find out what actually happened. So a few months ago I did a YouTube short. That short went sort of viral.
Hey creators, let's talk about YouTube Shorts.
A short is basically YouTube's answer to TikTok. Most of the videos are total garbage, just like TikTok, and I had really no interest in joining that landfill. But since other history channels threw in their garbage, I joined in too. Yes, I have no standards. But if you can't beat them, join them. The short is nothing special, it's just aimed at getting people to talk about the subject, and the text provided in the video is designed to do that. In the short, I gave a simple and nonsensical conclusion to what we are looking at. Is it a shell, or maybe a fragment of film? It's this type of playing dumb that simply seems to work, and a lot of YouTubers use this tactic. You can actually look at my better made shorts and see that the best ones don't do anything and only get 1k views. In this video, I want to look further into the video that has been circling around for some while now, which is mostly labeled as a shell bounce, which is complete nonsense. The video in question was actually filmed on the 25th of August during the liberation of Paris. That morning, crowds gathered in the southwest of the city to welcome the French troops. Later, the American forces would enter the city, and they were all greeted by French civilians. That same morning, German command would also sign a ceasefire, but fighting would break out and German snipers would open fire on the civilian crowds and the French forces. In this segment of video, you can see three French Sherman tanks and one Stuart clearing out small German resistance out of several buildings. The second Sherman in line even went so far to ram a barricaded door, and that's where the clip mostly ends. So I had a look at some of the newsreels that covered this part of the battle, and I think I found them all. What's interesting is that the footage in question has been edited out of some of the American newsreels and out of the Pathé production Paris Delivered. But the Movietone productions seem to all have these scenes still in there. The British Movietone Vive Paris and Liberation of Paris all seem to have different scenes, but have the same scene all with edited sound.
The French armored division with new American equipment is speedily crushes the remaining Nazi resistance in the city, and the battle for Paris ends with the final turmoil of a series of clashes. Tanks for battering ram.
A newsreel numbered CF833 seems to have really clear shots from the steward running down the street, and it seems it was nicknamed Metz. Sadly, I could not find any information on this vehicle. Other footage numbered 1408 shows a longer shot of the Stuart and the Sherman tanks further in the background, with the French Red Cross carrying away a wounded soldier. Searching online where this actually was, I found that it was filmed at Rue de Constantine, close to the Hotel des Invalides. Sherman tank that eventually hits the door seems to carry the number 19. The scene with the steward and the door would play out further in the back on the street, the Robert, the Anne, Robert the Ennobled Tree. The building they're actually shooting at is the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. You can still see the damage on the building today. But let's go to the actual interesting part of this video and also try and find a better quality frame for the round impact and have a good look in what it actually is. We can also have a look at the comments of the original short, and many people said in the comments that it was a tracer round, others say that it was a fragment of film or just edited in and simply fake. But since the editor in 1944 edited in sound to this clip, it was probably not edited in.
Snipers are still entrenched.
The other majority of people think it was a big round or a shell, simply because they are fooled by the misleading size. So why does it look like a big round? Now that's because of the film quality and because the round is forming heat. So you are actually looking at the shape of the warmth of the object, and this would make the round look bigger than it would actually be in real life. So this would mean it's a tracer. So what actually is a tracer round? Now, tracer ammunition are bullets that are built with a small bit of magnesium in their base. When fired, the magnesium ignites and it will burn very brightly, making the projectile trajectory visible to the naked eye during daylight and very bright during nighttime firing. This allows the shooter to visually trace the flight of the path of the projectile and thus making necessary ballistic corrections. So if it's a tracer, where did it come from? Now the answer to that lies in this great quality footage. You can actually see the round coming from extremely close range, probably from a fourth vehicle. You can see the puff of smoke after they fired their gun. The soldier talking to the commander of the Stuart actually reacts to this, and so does the second soldier in the back. After that, some of the other soldiers on the rear move up, and the second reel shows the Sherman crashing into the door. And several rounds are fired. The tank moves back, and that's the end of the clip. It also turns out there was a second cameraman filming this section in a reel numbered 1409. You can see the Sherman ramming the building, but not the 4th tank or the 30 or 50 cal tracer round footage. The Sherman moves back, and it sadly doesn't seem to have a nickname, because that would make identification of this vehicle a lot easier. Another reel shows there was actually a third cameraman named Sergeant R. Meyer, which filmed further in the back, seeking cover behind a Greyhound armored car, filming shots of the Stuart nicknamed Metz. Sadly, it did not film the trace around or the fourth mystery vehicle. But that's pretty much it. Even though there seems to have been three camera personnel present, nobody filmed the mystery vehicle. But my guess is that it was this Greyhound we see for a few seconds. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments below, what vehicle do you think it was that fired the tracer round? And if you want to see more of these analysis videos. If you want to support the channel, have a look on my Patreon or buy me a coffee, or have a look on my merch store. I will see you in the next one.